about the spirometer, okay? We talked about the total lung capacity, we talked about the vital capacity, we talked about the functional residual capacity, and all the things. First, we will invest in, 1 minute, we will get a review of that, and then we will compare these two things with that the spirometer. Now, what is the spirometer and what is the spirometer? How it is done. Okay, you people have to tell me. Because in the last lecture, I already talked about in a very detail. What is this? This is the residual volume. Okay, done, good. Now, this is what?
The expiratory volume.
This is expiratory reserve volume. Okay, good. Now, what is this?
Tidal volume.
And now, what is this?
Inspiratory
reserve volume. Done with this part?
Yes.
Now, listen. What is actually this? Lung
capacity.
Okay. What about this?
Inspiratory reserve volume, tidal volume, vital capacity.
Don't let the board. I just don't rub it. I didn't rub it for that. So that in the spirometer, then you can easily correlate with this thing and the that thing. Now this is the vital capacity. How about if we're talking? This is functional. You don't remember that, or you're not you don't want to tell me. Residual
capacity.
Okay. And what about the other thing? That is the whole thing. What is the functional residual capacity? Now, one thing you need to be left is the. This is what? Inspiratory by adding the tidal volume and the residue in the inspiratory reserve volume. And this is the inspiratory capacity. Functional residual capacity, residual volume, and the inspiratory reserve volume, and the tidal volume. What is the vital capacity? The inspiratory reserve volume, tidal volume, and the inspiratory reserve volume. Total lung capacity is a total of things, which is 6 liters. And this was about the capacities and even the volumes. Volumes we talked about in the review on the capacities together. Now we will see that actually what the spirometer is. Spirometer is a kind of apparatus in which we can have the knowledge about these three things, which is the tidal volume and the inspiratory reserve volume. Inspiratory reserve volume and the tidal volume. These two, or we can say this inspiratory capacity, would be measured by the spirometer. Why we cannot measure this thing? Due to the reason that it cannot, this is the volume that we cannot bring out of the lungs. Okay?
Okay. Listen.
For example, this is the normal lung that we are talking about. And from here, the lung, at this point, we attach a kind of pulley over here, and it is bound in that of the drum. Okay, let me make the drum a little bit, this is the air filled drum, okay? This is the air drum. And this is fixed on that particular part. This is the air drum. This is the pulley. Here is an arm. And it is attached with this. Now, here is another pointer attached to the pulley that is going to be attached with that of the paper. Okay? If we attach this air drum with that piece of the paper, so whenever your lungs will be, this is the apparatus that we actually have in that particular. This is
people can understand. But actually, you will inspire and expand the complete formation of the patterns over here, and we will say that the circularly it will move. We will move that, we will rotate that paper. Automatically that will be creating, and then we will have a pattern. How we will have a pattern? That there would be a pointer over there.
Okay.
And there is an ink really, ink on present on that. At this point, when you will inspire, this will go up, the pulley will go
down.
So that will be forming a pattern which is called as the wave. Like, there would be the wave formation. Firstly, you will expire, and then you will inspire, and you will see that what is the tidal volume and the stuff like that. And so you will be seeing that particular thing.
Like, by expiring, the wave goes down.
By inspiring, the wave goes down. This is the point that is coming. This would be inspiration. You see, why it's coming down? Because in expiration, you are adding pulley is going up and pointer is moving down. Are you getting my point? What I'm talking about? So, this is inspiration, this is expiration, but actually, this whole point over here, this is
inspiratory reserve volume.
This is inspiratory reserve volume due to the reason that we took that more than we needed air. More than we needed air, that the eardrum will be given to that of the lung. The pulley will go that much oxygen, okay, to the maximum level. So this would be called as the
inspiratory reserve volume.
Maximum inspiration. Now you see that you've done with this thing. Afterwards, then you will start breathing normally. But what if you expire your maximum? What if you expire your maximum? There would be the maximum expiration. Why? That the pulley you are putting extra amount of the air in the drum, the pulley is going up. When the pulley is going up, the extra, this would be unduly going downwards. This point will be unduly going downwards, and this is known as the maximum expiration. Okay? This is one. Now, you see that this would be the maximum inspiration and the maximum expiration. The whole this part is called as the total lung capacity. Okay, this is called as the total lung capacity. This is the maximum rate your lung can accumulate. This is the maximum expiration that a lung can accumulate. But you see, we have missed one thing. Listen, here is the point where we are saying that residual volume is present within the lung.
Yes.
Now, this residual volume cannot be come over here, and that particular air cannot affect this particular residual volume. So, the residual volume that will be presented at this particular point. So, this is the residual. But the pointer cannot point it over there.
Okay.
Okay, you get that? So the total lung capacity would not hold the maximum inspiration, maximum inspiration, this would be up till residual volume 2. But we cannot measure this total lung capacity with this spirometer due to the reason we cannot know about the residual volume. Okay? This spirometer cannot tell about the volume. We will talk about that. What is the how can we get about this spirometer? But up till now we have discussed the residual volume cannot be detected by the spirometer. Okay? Exactly. It will just measure that of the the vital capacity, which is the maximum inspiration. Maximum inspiration, or you can call it the inspiratory reserve volume. Inspiratory reserve volume, and the volume. That is what you will get to know about that. That particular. After this, we will be moving on to the thing that here up to here. What is this point called as? This is known as the vital capacity. What about the functional residual? Functional residual capacity is the residual volume and its vital reserve volume. So, spirometer can also not measure functional residual capacity. Functional residual capacity and the residual volume, they both can't be measured by the spirometer method. Okay, so
total lung capacity is also
exactly, we are saying that total lung capacity is also not measured by the spirometer. Inspiratory capacity, we talked about what is the inspiratory capacity. Inspiratory capacity is the inspiratory reserve volume and the tidal volume. What is this? Inspiratory
volume and tidal volume.
It's not this is not the total lung capacity, or this is not the vital capacity. Vital capacity we have already talked about or over here. This is actually the inspiratory capacity. tidal volume plus the expiry reserve volume. Okay? You get that? This is the tidal volume. So this is the tidal volume at the end. Up over there is the mean inspiratory reserve volume, inspiratory reserve volume, and the tidal volume. They both are called as the inspiratory. Okay, done with this part. Any questions? Easy.
Yes.
Now we talked about the functional. What about the functional restrictive? So spirometer cannot measure the residual volume. It cannot measure the volume 1 of the volume 2. Volume 1 means residual volume and spirometer is a volume which is created by the functional capacity. It cannot be measured by that, and the total non capacity. The only thing we can measure is the inspiratory capacity, the tidal volume, and the volume. Okay? Now we will see on the back of the graph that what is vital capacity, forced vital capacity. Now we will further on be talking about the forced vital capacity. Forced vital capacity means that maximum force you are applying to have the inspiration, and maximum your force that you are applying to have the expiration together. This is called as the forced vital capacity, in which you are putting the force in that. Okay. Now you see that we are having a little graph over there. Then, now here is the time, and here is the volume. But we have got again also 1.5, which is the residual volume, and also the residual volume and the expected reserve volume. So that would be making, that would be added to that other force vital capacity, that would be making the total lung capacity. Okay. So the draws are very important in that of the respiratory physiology. You have to be very concerned about that. Forced vital capacity is one particular type of the one. Get to know about that?
Yeah.
Okay, let me take a little test of you, and then we are done with the spirometer. Now afterwards we will be seeing the forced spirometer and the component function test, how they are present. Okay. Up here, we will be talking about the inspiration. What? Inspire? And down here, we will be talking about the
expiration. Okay.
Just think about a point that we have a pointer over here. We are not creating that spirometer particularly. Okay, we are just having that spirometer over here, and then we are going to talk about that. Okay, you see that when you will have the pointer and when you will inspire, the wave will go up or down.
Oh.
This will be going upward. This is the normal resting at resting position. Now you will have to tell me the normally this is inspiration, expiration. Inspiration is the wave is going up. Expire, that is the normal breathing, and it will come down. Then it will also come again. I will inspire, it will go up. Again I will expire, it will go
down.
Down. For example, if you say me that, okay ma'am, do you think that inspire to the maximum level?
Maximum expansion.
This is the maximum inspiration. The wave will be going to the maximum level. Okay, you get that? I inspire to the maximum level. What it is called as? This is called as a tidal volume. Inspiratory reserve volume. Okay, inspiratory capacity means exactly inspiratory capacity. Done with this thing. For example, if I start inspiring again now, but what if you say that expire to the maximum level now? At that particular point, what it will be called? Expiratory reserve volume. This part is called as the expiratory reserve volume. But actually, expiratory reserve volume, and also along with that, here below that there is also a point, which is what? This is the residual volume. What about that? Residual volume can come out of the lungs or not?
No.
Okay. It cannot come out of the lungs if you have the residual volume and the expiratory reserve volume. Together, what they are called as?
Functional.
This is called as a functional residual. Residual volume, we are saying that this is the group volume. We have tidal volume. Tidal volume is this one. Now, if you say me that,
so we use some other devices to functional residual capacity.
Yes. Now you have to tell me, what is this? So maximum inspiration and maximum expiration, these both together would be called as
volume capacity.
This would be called as the volume
capacity.
So you can measure the volume capacity, you can measure the inspiratory capacity, you can measure the tidal volume, you can measure the inspiratory reserve volume, you can measure the expiratory reserve volume. But you cannot measure the residual volume and the functional residual capacity. Okay?
Yes.
Done with this thing? Any confusion? In the spirometry?
No.
No? Easy? Okay. Let's have a break and talk about the... Or you wanted to know about the whole...